We're going to say that temperature is a measure of the thermal energy in a substance. We're going to say that temperature is independent on the amount of matter that we have. So basically, it doesn't matter how much we have of a substance, the temperature is the temperature. So for example, if I have a cup of water versus a gallon of water, their masses are very different. One weighs more than the other. But if they're both at 100 degrees Celsius, they're both at 100 degrees Celsius. So basically, temperature doesn't depend on how much I have of the substance. We're going to say that this is an example of an intensive property. An intensive property is a property that is not based on the mass or volume of an object. We're going to say besides temperature, we can say that boiling point, melting point, density, color, or hardness of metals are all considered intensive properties. None of them are based on the amount of mass or volume that I have of a particular substance. Now, concepts like density, some of you may not know what that is. We'll get to that later on in the chapter and talk about it more in depth later on in the semester. Now, we're going to say heat is also a form of thermal energy, but unlike temperature, heat is very dependent on the amount of matter. So basically, we go back to that example of that cup of water versus that gallon of water. Now, they both might have the same temperature, but the amount of heat coming from them will be very different. The 1 gallon of water will have more heat coming from it because there's more of it. The cup of water will have much less heat coming from its emanating from its source because there's just less water to begin with. We're going to say properties that are based on mass or volume are called extensive properties. So if they're asking for the mass of an object, so mass is an extensive property, volume is, say, moles, molar mass, anything dealing with weight or volume is an extensive property.